Again, soles of your feet together, knees out wide. Starting to connect with the breath. And again, I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong, but I'm going to do it gently. Let's start practice. Starting down on our backs, soles of our feet together, knees out wide. I'm afraid that I need to have just a little bit more space because you won't be able to see me if I'm standing. There we go. Hopefully that's enough. If it's not, I'll just do this. Again, starting to connect with the breath. Breathing into a four count. Holding to a four count. And exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction. From the tops of your throats down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts to track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four. And exhale, two, three, four. Again, inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. One more time, inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. And one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up those right obliques as you do, releasing toxins. Inhale, back to center. And exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up those left obliques as you do. And smile, it's Monday. Inhale, back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows, rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys. And then grab your insteps, drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet, pull down with your hands in happy baby. And again, dragging those shoulders back and down. Maybe rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys as you do. Again, and smile. It's Monday. And then draw those legs to center. Bend your knees. Cross your right leg over left. Wrap your feet. Right arm under left. Wrap your arms. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Equal arms, equal legs. Exhale, elbows to knees. Eagle crunches. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. And again, two more or seven more, wherever you are. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. You could stop here or follow us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Two more if you're with us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. And exhale forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind. Give yourselves a hug. And then cross that left leg over right, wrap your feet. Left arm under right, wrap your arms. Good job. And then from here, inhale first. As you touch your fingers and toes to the mat, exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Two more or seven more. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. And again, you can stop here or follow us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. And again, two more if you're with us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. And exhale forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Rock back and forth, and then exhale your legs to the end of the mat. Roll over onto the left side, left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale that right knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you, drag that right shoulder back and down in infinity pose. And again, possibly grab on to that right calf, draw your leg in a deeper stretch if this is in your practice. Inhale that right knee in, exhale down to the end of the mat, roll over onto your right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, drag that left shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out. Possibly drag your leg in if this is in your practice. In infinity pose. Again, either the deeper stretch or you can stay where you are. Inhale that left knee in. Exhale down to the end of the mat. Good job. Draw your knees in. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again, allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. We'll do three or four of these. And arrive at the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose. And then from here, let's go ahead and express gratitude. Again, inhaling gratitude as we lift our arms up, and exhaling as we release whatever doesn't serve us down to Anjali Mudra. Inhale those arms up. And exhale as you drag your hands down to Anjali Mudra. Inhale up. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. One more time. Inhale up. Open your hearts as you do, and exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and extend our legs in front of us. Flex your feet, and then make sure that you're on your sit bones. Remove any flesh. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, as you twist to the right, again, opening up east and west, and then drag that left elbow down on the outside of your right knee. Make mudras with both sets of fingers. Again, in twisted dandasana, opening up those right obliques. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, as you open up, to the left. And again, drag that right elbow on the outside of your left knee. Make
mudras with both sets of fingers. And smile. Inhale back to center. Exhale, reach, 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 reach. As far as you can with a flat back. Place your arms on either side of your calves. Inhale, halfway up. And exhale, down, chin to shin. And then just curl in Dandasana. Staff pose. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you bend your right, left knee. Let's go left knee first. Sit up straight, flex that right foot. Inhale both arms all the way up. And exhale all the way down this time. Reach, reach, reach. Flat back. We're moving into half Dandasana, chin to shin. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you draw that knee to center. And then from here, reach back with that left hand wrapping that left knee. Reach back with your right hand again. Possibly interlacing your fingers if this is in your practice. Open up to the right side through the breath. Opening your hearts. Exhale back to center. Cross that left leg over your right. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale as you place it on the outside of your left knee. Open up to the back of the room. Drag those shoulders back and down. Good job. Inhale, back to center. Exhale as you release both legs. Shake it out. Good job. Sitting up straight. Inhale first. Exhale. As you bend that right knee, dragging your right heel in towards your sit bone, flex your left foot. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, reach, 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 reach. All the way down, chin to shin, and then just curl in. In, half Dandasana, and again, breathing in and out. Inhale, as you walk those hands back again. Exhale, as you draw your knee in. Reach back with that right hand around that right knee. Reach back with your left hand. Take a bind if you can. And open up to the side wall through the breath. Keep that left foot flexed. Good job. Job. Inhale back to center, cross that right foot over your left knee. Inhale your right arm up. Exhale as you place it on the outside. Wait, no. Your left arm up, I'm sorry. You've already twisted that way. Place it on the outside of your right knee. Open up to the back of the room. Twisting, drawing those shoulders back and down, releasing toxins as you do. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend your legs and shake them out. Good job. Cross your legs. And then from here, let's go ahead and place our hands on the mat. Roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees. And if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Let's go ahead first and an inhale to cow. Drag your spines down, look up towards the ceiling, opening up those spines. Exhale as you bend your elbows as you transition into cat. Dragging your spines up, gazing at your navels. Inhale to cow. Again, looking up towards the ceiling. Dragging your spines down as much as possible. Exhale. Cat, good job. One last time, inhale. Opening up those spines as you do. And then exhale to cat. Good job. Come back to a flat back. Let's go ahead and inhale that right arm straight out. Left leg goes back. We're in sunbird. Flex your foot. Thumb is up, looking out gently beyond the mat. Wrap that right arm around. Bend your knee. Grab onto your ankle and pull up into modified dancer, modified bow pose. Again, breathing in and out in this balanced position. Exhale down. Inhale, that left arm straight out. On the edge of the carpet here. Right leg goes back, flex your foot, thumb is up. Again, we're in sunbird, looking out gently beyond the mat. Wrap that left arm around, bend your knee, grab your ankle and pull up into modified dancer, modified bow pose. Good job. Exhale down. And then from here, curl your toes under. Sit back on your heels. Make infinity symbols with your wrists. Open up your wrists. Open up your toes as well. Draw those arms overhead. If this is in your practice, draw your tailbone in the Utthita. Possibly draw those hands behind you, fingertips touch, pushing your fingertips up towards the crowns of your heads. Again, in Anjali Mudra behind your back. Shoulders are back and down. Breathing in and out. And we do this for 1 minute. Opening up those toes, opening your shoulders, your fingers, and your wrists. Breathing in and out. And smile, it's Monday. Had a little rain yesterday, which is very exciting. Not much, but a little. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Walk forward on your elbows. Clap up your toes. Good job. And then from here, quick, just put the speaker down. Plant the palms of your hands in the center, at the top of the mat. Curl your toes under, inhale, arch. Exhale, as you come back, down dog. Again, dragging your hearts towards your thighs. Planting the palms of your hands into the mat.
well. Take the pressure off of your wrists. Maybe walking the dog. Lifting first one heel and then the other. Stretching out your calf muscles as you do. Good job. Inhale that right leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. Exhale as you swing
to a lunge.
Plant your back foot. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana, one warrior down. Again. Pinky fingers are in, holding space. Fierce warriors. Exhale. Virabhadrasana, two. I think I'm going to adjust my camera really quickly. Stay where you are in Virabhadrasana 2. And again, in Virabhadrasana 2, reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Open up your right obliques. Exhale back, straighten your front leg, place your hands on your hips, drag that left hip back, right hip forward. Our hips should be squared to the sidewall as much as possible. Float those arms up, reach, 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 and then burst. Into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Again, keep pulling that left hip back, right hip forward. Come in to side angle again. In side angle. Possibly rotate that left arm around and forward towards your third eye. And feel that energy coursing from your left foot all the way through your fingertips. Good job, Utthita, upside angle. Draw your arm back to center. Take a wrap if this is in your practice. Maybe take a bind, reach under and grab that wrist, dragging that arm down towards the mat, opening your shoulder. Come back, north and south. And again, either launch off your back foot into Ardha Chandrasana or stay right here where you are, planting that right hand in front of you if you're with us, lifting your back leg, flexing your foot to the wall in Ardha Chandrasana. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. Don't feel like you have to. And again, maybe cup your right hand, lifting it off the mat or the floor in a balanced position. But don't feel like you have to. Release that leg. Bend your front knee and tip yourselves back. Virabhadrasana 2 once again. If you're still on the mat in side angle, look down and inhale up into Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that right leg back. Three-legged dog split. And go for your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Wherever you are is perfect. Good job. Inhale through your nose and side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Good job. And this time, inhale that left leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. Exhale, swing it through to a lunge. Plant your back foot, 45 degree angle.
middle. Inhale, up. Virabhadrasana. One. Warrior one. Good job. Fierce warrior. Shoulders back and down. Pinky fingers in. Exhale. Virabhadrasana. Two. And again, make sure that your back foot is parallel to the front of the mat. Reach, 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 all the way as far as you can. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Release toxins. Exalted warrior. Exhale back. Straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Pull that right hip back. Left hip forward. Float those hands back up again. Reach, 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 reach. And then burst. Into Trikonasana, Triangle Pose. Again, look up, see your thumb, make sure you're not twerking. Bend that front knee, coming into side angle. And then rotate that right arm around and forward. Reaching up for your third eye. Feeling that energy coursing from the right side of your right foot all the way through your fingertips in the Uttita side angle. Come back to center. Take a wrap. Possibly take a bind, reach under and grab wherever you can on that right arm. Again, dragging that right shoulder down towards the mat. Opening your arch to the side wall through the breath. Open up, north and south once again. And then again, you can either stay here or launch off your back foot, tipping yourselves. Coming in to Ardha Chandrasana, flexing your right foot to the wall. Again, you can take a bind if this is in your practice. You can also cup that left hand, lifting it off the mat in a balance, but don't feel like you have to. Open up once again. Bend that left knee, tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. Good job. If you're on the mat, look down, inhale up to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that left leg back and go through your vinyasa. Or simply meet us in Down Dog. Wherever you are is perfect. Inhale through your noses, sigh it out, inhale. One more time, inhale. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat, shoulders back and down. Backs are flat. Again, draw your tailbone in as much as you can. We're in bear pose. Step or jump up. Lighter than air. Inhale. Halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Again, shoulders are back and down. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Standing forward fold. Slightly bend your knees. Inhale all the way up. Swan that back one. Hands come together. Slight back bend. Hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. And then from here, we're going to move to balance. I'll step back so you can see me. And it's always good in balance to find a stable surface, so you don't need to be on your mat or on the carpet. You can be on wood floor, on tile floor, wherever you are. Again, all four corners of your feet are drawing into the earth. Lift your toes. Tadasana, calf muscles moving inward, thighs are moving inward, pelvis down the back, abdomen is in, our shoulders are back and down, and the crowns of our heads are moving towards the heavens. Our hands are open to receive. And again, find a drishti or a focal point. It's going to be kind of hard for me because we have so many beautiful birds drinking out of our pool right now. But I'll try. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that right tippy toe. Draw your right heel to your left ankle, to your left calf, or to your left thigh. Wherever you are is perfect. Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale, those arms out overhead into Talasana or palm tree. Again, pinky fingers are in. Utthita, draw those hands together. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Good job. Draw your knee to a marching position. Flex your foot. Inhale, those arms up overhead into stork. Good job. Utthita, hands come together. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and work on extension. Extend that leg. Keep your foot flexed. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And then bend your knee, drawing it back to a marching position. Inhale first. The other side. Starting into the asana again. They're all so beautiful, and these chicks are so big now, which is wonderful. It's always so exciting to see all of them grown up. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra, and then draw your heel to your left heel. To your right ankle, to your right calf, or to your right thigh, wherever you are is perfect. In Vrikshasana A, B, or C, dragging that left knee back towards the back wall as much as possible. Inhale, those arms all the way up. Again, into Talasana or palm tree, pinky fingers in. Utthita, draw those hands together, and exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Draw your knee to a marching position, flex your foot. Inhale, those arms up overhead, into stork. Utthita, and exhale down. And again, inhale first, exhale as you extend that left leg, hold it, hold it, hold it, and then bend your knee, coming back to a marching position, inhale first, three, two, one, and exhale down, good job. Coming up, mats once again. Standing at the top of our mats, inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, halfway up.
step back with that left foot. Walk your right foot all the way across. Right knee down,
left knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back.
Again, we're in Royal Pigeon. Maybe take Venus Mudra
if this is in your practice, or simply place your hands on the mat in front of you.
And then exhale down, humbly bowing yourselves. Again, placing that left cheek on the mat if this is in your practice. But you can also place your right cheek. You can have your elbows on the mat. You can also be on your backs. And again, make sure that you draw your hands back towards your waist before you release. Keep your shoulders
safe.
Again, we're in resting pigeon. We're releasing whatever emotions we may be storing on that right hip. Breathing in and out in resting pigeon. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Coming off on your right hip. Swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. In the Mariandrasana twist. Again, opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Inhale to center and exhale as you extend that left leg. Flex your foot. Moving into Janushasana. Inhale both arms all the way up. Twist to the left and exhale down. Reach, chin to shin. And then just curl in as far as you can. Again, in Janushasana. Maybe place your right hand over your right kidney, forcing the breath into your kidney, keeping it healthy as you do. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. And then exhale as you bend your knee. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that right leg. Flex your foot. Inhale both arms all the way up. Twist to the left and then exhale down. Reach. Chin to shin. And then just curl in. Again, in Janushasana, possibly place your left hand over your left kidney, forcing the breath into your kidney as you do. Puffing it out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you extend both legs. Shake it out. Come up to the tops of your mats in Balasana, yogi squat. Placing the backs of your biceps just below your knees. All four corners of your feet are growing into the earth. Lift your toes. Again, you can stay here, or you can place your hands just in front of you, either on the mat or on the floor. Rocking back and forth, finding that sweet spot, and then moving into enough room here. Back up. I'm going to run right into that stand. Into Bakhasana again. We're in crow pose, working on our core strength, arm strength, and bone density, but don't feel like you have to.
You can stay here as long as you want to. We're going to move back to Malasana. Inhaling from our root chakra all the way up to our crown chakra. And exhaling down again. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Good job. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up. To Ardha Tadasana. And then take a giant step back with your right foot. Walk that left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Possibly take Venus Mudra if this is in your practice, but don't feel like you have to. And exhale down. Again, placing that right cheek on the mat if this is in your practice. Breathing in and out. And smile. It's Monday, the start of a new week. Releasing any unwanted emotions that you may be storing on your left hip. Make sure that you draw your hands back towards your waist before you release them. Good job. In resting pigeon. Inhale as you walk those hands back, coming up on that left hip. Swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in. And your left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. In the Mariandrasana twist. Releasing toxins. Massaging our internal organs as you do. Opening your hearts. Extend your legs, shake them out. Place the soles of your feet on the mat. Arms are out east and west. No, beside your knees, not east and west. Just beside your knees. Hands are open to receive. Inhale first. Exhale, inch by inch. Vertebra by vertebra. Down to the mat, and when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Take your block in the hands. Draw your heels in. Inhale as you push your hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, second or third levels, wherever you are is perfect. Again, possibly draw those arms overhead. Maybe walk your feet out in front of you in a T formation or a mushroom formation. Opening up that lower back region even more. Like you have to. You can keep those arms down beside you, in beneath your sit bones. And then when you're ready, draw those arms back overhead, walk your feet in. Inhale as you push your hips up. Release the block and exhale down. Good job. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and forth. And then from here, let's go ahead and extend our legs above us in legs straight up, allowing the circulation to come back down to our vital organs, back down to our brains. And then if this is in your practice, push your hips up above you,
Again, into a shoulder stand, walking your shoulders under, looking like a candlestick. Feet are in Barbie feet. Draw those toes overhead. If this is in your practice, into Halasana or Plank Pose. Again, don't feel like you have to. Possibly bend your knees, placing them around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming back down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Good job. And exhale that right leg down. Inhale your left arm up overhead. Exhale as you push your left knee over to the right in a full body twist. Look over to the left. Inhale back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and and then exhale that left leg down. Inhale your right arm up overhead. Exhale that right knee over to the left. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Inhale back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. And again, inhale for your noses, side out, inhale. One more time, inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso, palms are up to receive, down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads. Relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed. Hands are at Anjali Mudra. Heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Monday. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you tomorrow. Again, today is the end of the month, and thank you so much for all of you who have already sent in your payments. And if not, you can do so by PayPal. Thank you.
Namaste. Thanks for being here. I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong once again. If I'll be here or in the casita, but either is fine. And I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording.